So Miss Minchin was very shocked to hear that Mr. Barrow met the news of Mr. Barrow. Mr. Barrow came that told that he did wanted to point out that he did not have any diamond mines. Mr. Q had did not have any diamond mines, as Mr. Q had been exploited by his friend. His friend had taken away all the money which was involved in the diamond mine. Here Miss Minchin stopped him with a gasp. Now Miss Minchin just opened mouth, she just stopped her. The late Captain Crewe, she cried out, the late, you don't come to tell me the Captain Crewe is. This the late Captain Crewe means what? Captain Crewe had already died. She could not believe the thing. That what are you telling? Means she asked Mr. Barrow to explain that what she he wanted to tell, that Captain Crewe had died. She could not believe it. When she was really very much surprised that how could this happen. He is a dead man, Mr. Barrow answered with a jerky brusqueness. So in a very shortness of speech, in a very sharp way, he just moved his body and he just answered in a very clear manner that Captain Crewe had died. Died of jungle fever and business troubles combined. So how he died? He had died of a jungle fever, a disease, and also business troubles. The jungle fever might not have killed him if he had not been driven by the business troubles and Captain Crewe's friends. So jungle fever might not have killed him. He would have survived. But what happened? The business troubles troubled him so much that Captain Crewe is dead. Miss Minchin dropped into her chair again. The words he had spoken filled her with an alarm. So Miss Minchin dropped her chair again. He just dropped and sat down on a chair. Miss Minchin was shocked. And the words which Mr. Barrow had spoken filled her with fear. What were his business troubles? She said. Now she has what were his business troubles? Diamond mines, answered Mr. Barrow, and dear friends and good. So diamond mines, his dear friends, the treachery. His dear friend had betrayed him. He had taken away all the money and left. So that was a ruin for him. Ruin, gasped Miss Minchin. Ruin means complete destruction. Lost every penny. The young man had too much money. The dear friend was mad on the subject of the diamond mine. So lost every penny. What happened? That young man had too much money. The dear friend was very mad on the subject of the diamond mine. He put all his money into it and all Captain Crewe's. So what happened? The friend of Mr. Crewe did not know anything about the business. He had involved the money of Mr. Crewe into the diamond mines. And he wanted to be rich. As a result, what happened? Mr. Crewe was completely ruined. Then the dear friend, what happened? When everything was lost, their dear friend ran away. Captain Crewe was already stricken with fever when the news came. So when the friend escaped, after exploiting him, after taking away his money, after investing his money, the news came. At that time, Mr. Crewe was very sick. The shock was too much for him. He died raving about his little girl and didn't have a liver pain. So at that time, he was very much shocked that he could not leave anything for Sarah. So really, Lavinia's remark had become true, that Sarah had become a beggar. Because his father, Mr. Crewe, died without leaving her anything. Nothing could be kept for Sarah. Now Miss Minchin understood, and never had she received such a blow in her life. Her show people, her show patron, swept away from the Silk Serenity at the one blow. Now Miss Minchin, who was very much attracted to money, who was very much had a fascination for money, she considered Sarah to be her show people. And at a moment, what happened? Her dream shattered. Everything had come to an end. When she said that her show people, the main object of attraction, that whom he showed to everyone, her show patron, means Mr. Crewe, whom he considered to be a very good businessman, and swept away from the Select Seminary at the one. So those whom he had appreciated, he had adored, he had Mr. Crewe and Sarah, whom she had appreciated, whom she had adored, were nothing but poor people. But they were nothing but paupers. not beggars. Similarly, means their condition was similar to the beggars. They were not rich. Their condition was very miserable and wretched. And this also happened in case of Sarah. She was dejected. She was totally shattered. And she felt that she had been robbed, and that Captain Crewe and Sarah and Mr. Barrow were equally to blame. At that time, she thought what? That she would be exploiting Sarah and she would be relaxing on Sarah's money. This was a thought. And at that time, she wanted to blame everyone. Captain Crewe, Sarah, Mr. Barrow, all were equal for to blame that her such a nice dream of her had been shattered. Now, Sarah would be remaining in a seminary without paying her money or without becoming an heiress. She would be just a beggar, just be depending on Miss Minchin's mercy. Now, do you mean to tell me, she cried out, that he left nothing, that Sarah is left on my hands, a little pauper instead of an heiress? So, she asked clearly to Mr. Barrow, if he wanted to state clearly that Mr. Barrow wanted to state clearly what? That Mr. Crewe had left nothing for Sarah. And Sarah would never become an heiress or never would be inherit large amount of property or fortune, but she would be just a beggar in the hands of Miss Minchin. She is careful, certainly a little beggar, replied Mr. Barrow. And she is certainly left on your hands, ma'am. And she hasn't a relation in the world that we know. Now, again, Mr. Barrow pointed out that it was really a surety that Sarah would be a beggar. Sarah did not have anything. And Sarah did not have any relations whom any one of Mr. Barrow knew. And she had nowhere to go other than living in the seminary of Miss Minchin, and she did not have relations. So Miss Minchin's dream was totally shattered. That how could this happen? How could this fatal thing happen? She just nurtured a dream that one day she would be rich with Sarah. She would be helping Sarah to manage her wealth. At the same time, she would be benefited. But her whole dream had been shattered. So, Lavinia's remark had become true in case of Sarah. And Sarah also became a beggar. And Sarah thought what? Sarah's life would become very difficult. And Sarah would be living on her imagination. Sarah was a very nice girl. And Sarah would be definitely dealing with the struggles of life in a very heroic manner. So this is the end of the story, Little Princess. Hope you will all enjoy it.